Good afternoon, dear students. So we were studying history, and this is the second part of our first lesson. And we studied what is history. We studied the importance of studying history. We studied about the history of India. And we also studied how do we get the information about the history. Today we are going to look at studying history. Under that we will see multiple perspectives. Now, what is multiple perspective? And we will see what is the importance of multiple perspective. We will see this two words, which is perspective and bias. We will see what does perspective mean, what does bias mean. And finally, we will see what is the need of having multiple perspective in studying history. Is it helpful or is it not? So let's go to our first topic, that is multiple perspective. Why do we need multiple perspective? Tell me the meaning of multiple. We all know what is multiple. Multiple is more than one. More than one or many is multiple. If it's just one, it's single. But when it's multiple, it means there's something more than one. Now, perspective. What is perspective? Perspective means point of view. Okay? Now, to make you understand this a little better, I will give you an example. So, let's choose something here. Okay, let's choose dotted line. So, okay. Right. If you know, this should be a tree. Okay, we are taking that as a tree, and trees have leaves. Okay, so let's just imagine it has a lot of leaves. Okay, and it has flowers, it has tiny fruits. Okay, it has fruits. Alright, now let's choose black. This is person A. And this is person B. Now, we will ask person A to tell us what does he see here in a single statement, and also person B to do the same. Now, imagine person A looks at the tree and says, the leaves are green. And this is the only statement person A spoke about the tree. And let's say person B says, the fruit is red. Okay. Now, the leaves are green is the perspective of person A about the tree. And the fruit is red is the perspective of person B about the same tree. Now, the tree is the same. Now, did person A tell the correct answer or did person B tell the correct thing? We know both of them told the correct thing because the leaves are green, that is true. The fruit is red, that is also true. However, each of them have their own point of view when it came to a tree. Okay, there is also another word Let's see that word now. Okay. There is a word. We saw perspective. There is a word called bias. What is bias? Bias means preference. Okay. Now, preference is the choice a person makes. I'll give you an example for this later. Let's come back to what we were looking at. So, this person's perspective is the trees are, the leaves in the tree is green, and the perspective of person B is the fruit in the tree is red. Now, if we look at this person's perspective, we only understand about the leaves in the tree. And if we look at only person B's perspective, we understand the fruit is red. But if we have to understand more about the tree, we have to look into the perspective of person A plus person B, so we get a detail about the tree. So when we look into both the perspectives, what do we understand? We understand that the tree, the leaves in the tree is green, and the tree also has fruits that is red. Now we have to implement the similar method when studying history. Okay, because there are many historians who wrote about many things in history. There is a historian who writes about kings and queens. There are others who has written about the farmers. Others who have written about the political system. And others who have written about the economy of the country and so on. Now, just because a ruler or a poet or a writer wrote about kings and queens, that does not mean 2000 or few years ago only kings and queens lived. Just because the author or the work person who wrote about a dynasty wrote about economical activities does not mean there was no other activities in a particular dynasty. That is only the perspective that the person chose to write. Okay, there are some writers who has written about kings and queens, like I told you earlier. It is only their perspective to write about the kings and queens. It is their personal choice. It is, and they have written it from their point of view, what they saw and what they thought is right. Now, just because they wrote about kings and queens, does that mean history is full of kings and queens? Absolutely no. Just because somebody wrote about farmers, does it mean history is full of farmers? Absolutely no. When there were kings and queens, there were also farmers. Just like our modern society, there is division. Even back then, there are division of labor. Back then, there are all kinds of people who are kings and queens, who are farmers, who are merchants, etc. So, somebody's perspective does not mean everything in a country is the same. It is just one person's point of view. So, why do we study about multiple perspectives? Here we say multiple perspective because we are supposed to take into consideration the perspective of everyone else's, not just one person. We should take perspective of more than one person. Okay? Let's go to this word. I told you perspective is point of view, and for this I gave you an example of a tree, where according to one person trees are filled with green leaves and according to another person it is filled with red fruit. Now this is just their perspective, point of view, what they think when they see a tree. Now bias or preference, what is the meaning of the word preference? I'll give you another example. Let's say there is an ice cream. Okay, did I do this correct? Okay. And let's say there is a piece of cake. Okay. All right. Never mind. So let's say there is a piece of cake. Let me try drawing the cake again. Okay, I'm not getting it. Okay, so let's say there is a piece of cake. Now, one person and another person. I would give them options that they can choose either the ice cream or the cake. Person A might choose the cake. Person B might choose the ice cream. Why? Because the preference of person A is a piece of cake, whereas the preference of person B is a ice cream. If every individual has their own preferences, has their own likes and dislikes. If I go out and look into the nature, I have my own preference. I might like looking at the birds more than looking at the trees. But there will be others who would like to look at the trees more than they look at the birds. In the same way, every author who wrote in the history, they were biased because they had their own preferences like every human being has. So they must have chose to write what they like. Okay. So there are some authors who have written about certain things in a kingdom and other authors who have written about other things in the kingdom. Now, let us see how this multiple perspective of all this author helps us to study history better. Now, let's draw some shapes here. I'll need some circle. Okay, circle 1, circle 2, circle 3. Yes. Okay. Now, let's say the first person spoke about kings, the second person spoke about economy, and the last person spoke about art or architecture. Now, if I, being a student of history or someone who studies history or an historian, who is an historian, someone who studies history. So I, being a historian, if I choose only to read this, I will only understand about the kings. If I choose to read this, I will understand about the economy of the dynasty. If I choose to read arts and architecture, I will only understand about the architecture of the particular dynasty. But if I choose to read all the three, I will understand about the king of the dynasty, economy of the dynasty, and architecture of the dynasty. So what is the importance of having multiple perspectives is this. I will read about the king, I will read about the economy, and I will also read about the architecture. And when I do a combination of studies, I will reach a point where I will know everything about the particular dynasty or the kingdom that I am studying. And this is the point where all the three circles meet. So let's mark this. And here is my knowledge And here I have knowledge of circle A, which is about the king. I have knowledge of economy. I have knowledge of architecture. And I will combine and study all the three. And when I combine and study all the three, automatically what happens, few of the part, which is biased or based on people's perspective, which is not important, will get eliminated, and the important portion of the history can easily be covered and learned only when I look at the multiple perspective, or only when I look at studying all the three perspectives. Okay? Right. So, that is the importance of having a multiple perspective in studying history. Now, let me try bringing it back. Where did it go? Okay, so that part is done, and let's see the fourth one. Right, here we know the importance of bringing both together. I will have a complete picture of what is happening. Okay. So I have A plus B, I will get the complete picture of what is happening. So what is important? Combination of combining. Studying by comparing and combining all the information that we have is important. Okay. So let's just have a quick recap. What we studied today, we studied about multiple perspectives. We studied multiple is more than one, perspective is a point of view. We spoke about being biased and preferences. We said perspective is point of view, bias is preference. And we studied about how multiple perspective helps us. Multiple perspective helps us because we will get to know what happened in all together than just knowing the little bit. When we have multiple perspective, we will understand everything about a particular system than understanding a part of it. And we said combination is important. Okay. So we are done here with this syllabus. So let's move on to the question and answers. Please take your textbooks so you can write it down and then later rewrite it in your classwork. So first one, I would encourage you to go through the glossary and write it down in the classwork. That will come for your test. Understand, I've already taught you most of the glossary words that is there. So, you can see there is my learning chart. I want you to do this as your homework and send it to me. Okay, my learning chart. It's easy. You only have to write two sources of history. We know there are multiple sources. It's in the textbook. And I want you to find out one problem of history. Okay? Now, fill in the blanks. First one, A, history links are dash with dash. History links, I told you, history links dash and dash. That is our path with a present. B, Dash are the people who study about the past. Who are the people who studies about the past? We just spoke. Historian. BC in history means 400 years. What is BC? Before Christ. Before Christ. 400 years before Christ was born. Okay. So, that is the answer. In the D it says, does history only inform us about the past? Explain with a reason. So, what does history teach us about? It teaches us about the past. So, the answer is, yes, history only informs us about the past. And what is the reason? Because history is the study of past. And why should we study history? And we taught this in the class. Do not worry, I'll send you the answer for that. So for option for questions 2 and 3, I will be sending you answer. And let's move on to match the following. A, B, C, D. I'm not going to write the words. Please write the full words in your classwork. So match the following. First one says site. Do you remember a site in Karnataka that we spoke about? So, site. Answer for site is Halur. Where is this place in? This is in Karnataka. So, the option is C. Now, I'll give you only the options from the second one. So, B. Literary sources. Now, what are literary sources? Something that can be read and written. Literary sources are written. Okay. So, do you remember something that is written by man is called a manuscript? Okay. Manuscript. And this is option D. For C, okay. Give me a minute here. Now, question 3. Archaeologists. Who is an archaeologist? Archaeologist is someone who finds and studies different sources. What kind of sources? Material sources. Okay. So, this is option. Answer is B. And for D, finally, archaeological sources. One of the examples for archaeological sources is option A, which is coin. So, please write this down in your classwork and do not forget to write this as your homework. And the rest of the answers, I will send it to you. And we will have to start studying because this chapter will be there for your first unit test of social science. So that is it for today. Have a good rest of your day. Thank you. And if you have any doubts or any questions regarding any of that we studied, we will give you a time and you can